Hi everyone, and welcome to Gwyn Collects. Welcome to part two of my pre-orders video. If you want to watch part one of this video and see all of the figures that I have pre-ordered up until wherever I decide to start this video, please go check out my video from last week. I will link it above and in the description. But yeah, go check out that video if you want to see the other pre-orders that I have made. Because I have made quite a few, that's why I had to split it into two parts. Yeah, so I don't really have much else to say for this intro, other than let's get into the figures, because as we can see by the fact that I had to split this video into two parts, there are a lot of them. Alright, after October and November, things start to cool down a little bit, mainly because figure prices have just gotten so insane. I still have some very expensive months, but they'll have like three figures in them and still be like $1,000. Like, figure prices are just wild. Anyway, for December right now, I have the Asuka Langley Shikinami version Radio Ava, original color and the normal color. I just love this figure so much and I couldn't decide between the two, so I pre-ordered both. I think I'll probably get both, but if I need to cut down on my spending, I'll probably axe the monochrome one, because I bought Ray in the colored version, as you'll see soon, and I'm gonna get Mari in the colored version, so I'll probably axe the monochrome Asuka if I have to cancel a figure. But I do love them both. I would like to have them both. Next up in December, I have the Murasaki Shikibu 1/7 caster figure by Alter. This is a Raita design. Main reason I got it is I'm a huge, huge Raita fan. I absolutely love Raita's figures, or Raita's designs, and then the figures based on Raita's designs. So when I saw this one, I just think she's so stunning and she's gonna look so good. I was thinking with Miss Orangette beside each other, they're just gonna be like witchy, gorgeous, sexy ladies, and I'm so excited about them. And the last, oh no wait, I got two more. Second last is the Fujiwara Chika Christmas present version by B-Box. I'm super excited about this figure. Of course I had to pre-order it, it's Chika. What do you want me to say? It's Chika, I had to pre-order it. And then finally I have the Iwaizumi Nendoroid re-release. Obviously, I'm gonna get them, because I have the Owakawa, and I would like, my little Iwaizumi to go with Owakawa. I was waiting for that re-release, so that was a pretty easy pre-order for me. Moving into January, it is a very Miku month in January of 2023. The first figure I have is one that got delayed from August to next January, and it is the Hatsune Miku Lamb Rock Singer version. 1/7 scale. I am so sad this figure got delayed. She was one of my most anticipated figures of 2022. I'm so sad that she got delayed, but I'll get her one day. Stronger always delays. I should have expected this, but that was a painful delay from August to January. I was like, oh, but yeah, so that one is in January. Additionally, the Hatsune Miku Symphony 5th Anniversary version is also in January. I'm still so excited about this figure. I still think this is my favorite Miku design. It's just so stunning. I love it so much. It's so beautiful. I also have the Hatsune Miku Project Diva Arcade Future Tone B-Style My Dear Bunny version. Very long name, but it is the quarter scale Bunny Miku. I was actually talking to my friend about this, and we were like on a video chat, and she was showing me, she has the Miku, and I was like so jealous. She was showing me it and I was like, wow, like I want it so bad, maybe they'll do a bare leg. And then like a few weeks later, the re-release happened with tights. It was wild. It was absolutely wild. It was the most insane like manifestation ever. So anyway, super hyped about that. I love this Bunny Miku design. I never thought I would own it because her aftermarket was so bad. So I'm so glad. Thank goodness for re-releases. Like, they're just amazing. So super, super excited about that one. I also have the Harmonia Humming Hatsune Miku doll. I've decided to start my foray into dolls. And I really, really love the Harmonia Humming line of dolls. I know some people don't like them and think they're creepy. I think they're absolutely gorgeous. They are quite expensive, like maybe overpriced, but I like their size a lot. I love the Dolphies, but they're like 1/3 scale and they're just so big that I do like the smaller size quite a bit. And I think they're really, really pretty dolls. I also love the Marin doll so much. So I will definitely be pre-ordering the Marin doll. And I might have another one on the way right now. A little wise wolf, maybe? But yeah, super, super excited to start collecting this line of dolls, and the Miku is just so gorgeous, so I had to pre-order her. I have one non-Miku figure in January, and it is the V-Singer Luo Tiani Unexplored Flower Garden Casual Wear version. This figure is so my vibe. The outfit that she's wearing is something I would totally wear, and I just love everything about the figure. The whole, like, kind of, like, chair and background, I just think it's so gorgeous, and I'm very excited to see how she turns out, so I'm super, super pumped about this figure. I think it's stunning. I'm so excited about it. I only have three figures in February, the first one being the Idolmaster Cinderella Girls Miyamoto Frederica, 1/7 Frey de la Mode version. This one is kind of on the chopping block right now. I absolutely love this figure. It's by Alter, and I think that the details in her outfit are just so gorgeous. I just think it's gonna turn out so stunning, and like, knowing Alter, they're just gonna nail it. Like, it's gonna be such a beautiful figure, but I don't know the character, and I think she's about 18,000 yen or 19,000 yen. Which is pretty expensive, so we'll see. She's on the chopping block, but I do really love the figure, so I might cancel and just try an aftermarket hunt her, because I feel like Idolmaster figures always go down in the aftermarket, but she is so stunning. I really do love this figure, but it's more the price and me not knowing the character that are kind of holding me back from like fully committing to it, you know? So we'll have to see how I feel as it gets closer to February. And the last figure I have pre-ordered for February 2023 is the Hatsune Miku Takin FNEX 1/7 Miku With You 2021 figure. I absolutely love this figure. I got it off of Tokyo Otaku Mode, so I've already paid for it. I'm so excited about her. I think she's stunning. She's just a beautiful work of art. I hummed and hawed about this figure for a while, and then I finally just bit the bullet, and I'm so glad I did, because I cannot wait to add her to my collection. And like, I love her so much, I don't even care that she's gigantic, you know? You know those figures where you're like, I don't know where I'm gonna put it, but I will make room? She's one of those figures, so I absolutely love her, super excited about her. Alright, next up we have March of 2023. I have a few figures in March. The first one is the Hatsune Miku Vampire Pop-Up Parade Large. I loved Echo 27. I love the song Vampire, so when I saw that they were doing this pop-up parade, I knew I had to have her. I think she turned out absolutely gorgeous. And I pre-ordered her pretty much. Well, actually, I did pre-order her instantly. That was an instant add to cart, instant pre-order. She's so stunning. I am so excited about her. Next up, I have the Makinami Mari Illustrious 1/7 Last Mission version figure by Revolve. I got the Oscar a few months ago. I absolutely love the Oscar. I love Revolve figures, period. So I knew when I saw the Mari that I had to have her as well. So it was a pretty easy pre-order. I love completing sets, especially of beautiful figures. So that was an easy pre-order. Another figure that I regret buying that is pre-ordered for March is the Uzui Tengen FNX. No. The Uzui Tengen Aniplex figure. I just feel dumb for pre-ordering this because every Demon Slayer figure goes down in the aftermarket and I should have just waited. I don't know why I pre-ordered him. And I think I paid like $300 Canadian with shipping and everything. Like, I know he's gonna tank and I'm not gonna have to pay that. Or I wouldn't have had to pay that if I hadn't pre-ordered him. But I don't think it's worth using up my one lifetime cancellation on Tokyo Otaku Mode, so I'm just gonna suck it up and cry that I didn't get a better price. I do want the figure, I just definitely shouldn't have pre-ordered him. I should have just waited and aftermarket hunted him. I'm just dumb. Next up, I have another Binding Bunny, probably my second most anticipated Binding Bunny right after Ringo, and it is the Lepus Chimomo 1/4 Bunny version. I know this one might not be everyone's cup of tea. I absolutely love her. I think she's just super fun and fresh. Who doesn't love a tanned figure? I think she's just beautiful. I love her like little twin tails, her earrings, her vibe. I love her like bunny ear visor. I'm super excited about that. So I fell in love with her the instant I saw her. I think she's just so stunning. Probably one of the best bunnies Binding has ever done, I think. But I'm super excited about her. I love some tanned bunny representation in my collection, so very excited about her. Next up, I have the Holo Chinese Dress version. This one went up for pre-order pretty recently. Very excited about her. I think it's by Katakawa? Yes. It is a 1/7 scale figure by Katakawa, and it is beautiful. I love her. I love her face. I love her outfit. I love her pose. I love the apple tray. Very excited to add yet another Holo to my collection. I might have more Holos than Chicas after next year. So next we're going to move into April of 2023. Next up I have the Shinobi Master Senran Kagura New Link Ryobi B-Style 1/4 bunny version. When I saw this bunny at one of the, I think it was at a Wonderfest or One Hobby, I knew I had to have her. Red is my favorite color, and I think her bunny suit is just so gorgeous. I love all of the details on her. I love her face with the tongue sticking out. I'm such a sucker for figures with their tongue sticking out, so I had to have her. I love everything about this figure, and I love that she's got a dump truck. Oh my god, that dumpy, like, it's crazy. Holy. Anyway, back on topic. She is gorgeous. I'm so excited to have her. And honestly, like, compared to some of the prices Freeing is asking for their new bunnies, cough cough, the mommy bunny that I pre-ordered and then promptly canceled the same day because I couldn't swallow that price, I feel like 36,000 yen is okay for the Ryobi bunny. I felt okay spending that because I feel like the bunny is very iconic and it's also cast off. Like, she's gorgeous. I love her. She's one of the few Freeing bunnies where I think she's worth the over 30,000 yen price tag, but still debatable. The next one I have pre-ordered is the Miku with Solwa scale. It's a 1/7 scale by Good Smile Company. I absolutely love this Miku. Beautiful streetwear Miku. How could I say no? I love, like, the wet look. Like, her hair almost looks like paint or something. I don't know. It's just so cool. I absolutely love her. Easy pre-order. She's stunning. And I was able to pre-order her on Amazon Japan, get a very nice shipping price. I love it. I love Amazon Japan. And I love this Miku, so very excited to pick her up. The next figure I have pre-ordered for April is the Evangelion series Rei Ayanami, tentative name, Millennials illustration version by Bbox and Alter. I'm so excited about this figure because she's gonna look amazing with the Jersey Asuka figure. I feel like everyone's trying to get their hands into the streetwear game. I've seen a lot more streetwear figures since the smashing success of the Radio Ava figures, so I'm very, very, very excited about this Rei. She's also being made by Alter, so I'm very excited because I know Alter's just gonna absolutely kill it. She's stunning. Ah, she's stunning. I love this Rei. I love this Rei so much. And finally, I have the National Treasure Zakusha Toshiho, which is the one with the pearls, I think. You know what? Thinking about it now, I feel like I forgot the deer one. I feel like the deer one is not in my spreadsheet. Maybe it comes out next year. Maybe it's coming up. But I also have the deer one, the Jataka of the Deer King. I feel like that was December. Huh. But yeah, I have the Pearl National Treasure Maethos figure and the Deer Maethos National Treasure figure. I'll just put them both on the screen. I have them both pre-ordered in whatever month the Deer one comes out. But the Pearl one comes out in April of 2023. And I am beyond excited for them both because they are so stunning. And I love Maethos so much. So I can't wait to see how they turn out. I think they're stunning. And I really, really love the Pearl one. I think she's just breathtaking. Like, the deer one came out and I was like, I don't think I've ever loved a figure more than this one. And then the pearl one came out and I'm like, nope, I do love a figure more than that one. The pearl one is just so stunning. I'm so excited about her. In May of 2023, the first figure I have pre-ordered is the Shinomi Akana 1/7 nurse version. I know this figure has brought some controversy to the community on my figure collection. I personally really like this figure. And I know some people think she's maybe a little bit lolly. And I completely understand that. I think she's really cute, and I don't think that, like, I think she's just is kind of like a smaller busted character. Her face is a little bit cutesy, I know, but I really, really love this figure, and I couldn't say no. I feel like she's a very borderline kind of figure, but she's one where I was just like, ah, I love her. So don't kill me, people who don't like her. She's really cute, and I wanted her for my collection, and I love nurse figures, so I'm sorry. But yeah, I did pre-order her, and she's being made by Annie Gift. I've never pre-ordered a figure from them before, but I'm excited to see what their figures are like. And then next up, I have the Original Deformed Figure DLC series, Tea Time Cats British Shorthair. I just recently got the first in the Tea Times Cats series, and I'm so excited about this one because she's so cute. I love this series from Ribos. They just are the most adorable figures, and my first Tea Time Cat turned out so fantastic. I can't wait to show you guys her, that I'm super excited for this next one in the series. I have two Binding Bunnies in April 2023 that are going to destroy my wallet. The first one is Mio Blue, the Sakiyamama Bunny by Binding. Obviously, I pre-ordered this one. I think she is so gorgeous, and I'll forever be sad that I didn't get Caroline Yuri. So, yeah, I love Mio Blue. I think she's stunning. I can't wait to get her. And she'll help fill the void in my heart that not having Mio Blue, or that not having Caroline Yuri makes. And then I also ordered the Shiori Binding figure. I absolutely love her. She like showed up on a Binding Tuesday and I was like, yep, add to cart. I know some people didn't like her as much. I was talking to people on Discord. Actually, you can join the Broken Figures Discord down in the description below. I'm on there pretty often. You can chat with me there. But I was chatting with some people on there and they didn't actually love this Binding figure, but I love her. I think she is so sweet and fun. Yeah, she was an instant pre-order for me. She's so cute, and I love cowgirls, so she was a definite yes for me. Next up, in June of 2023, I have a single figure pre-ordered right now, and it is the Ayanami Rei 1/7 version Radio Eva Part 2. It is the color Radio Eva figure. I really love the second line of illustrations, so of course I went with the color. It was kind of hard to choose if I wanted to do color or monochrome, but I ended up going with color in the end because I love color. I told myself I would get monochrome for this part two line, and I couldn't do it. I just love color so much, you know? Alright, moving on to July of 2023. I have one figure pre-ordered for this month currently, and it is the Idolmaster Shiny Colors Sarizawa Asahi 1/7 Sora to Ao to Aisu version. Or Aitsu version. again, another Idolmasters figure that I pre-ordered, but this one is not like Frederica. This one I pre-ordered because I can't imagine a life that I live without this figure in my collection. It is so beyond gorgeous. It was love at first sight. I saw this figure and it's just everything I love. Like, Alter really popped off. Like, Alter, what? And like, honestly, her price is about 36,000 yen. I pre-ordered her on AmiAmi. And I feel like that's a very fair price for the level of detail of this figure. Like, Eastream is crying right now, seeing these prices that Alter can charge. But I know Alter will just absolutely nail her. And like, I love everything about it. I love the like style of the main character in this figure. And I love how like the streetlight has like the like digital stripes around it. Like, it just is such a unique figure. It's like a whole like sculptural piece, in my opinion. I think she is unbelievably gorgeous, and I had to have her. Like, I just absolutely had to have her. So I am so excited about this pre-order. Alright, now for my August of 2023, I have one figure pre-ordered, and it is the Good Smile Racing Hatsune Miku 1/7 Racing 2010 figure. This is by Max Factory. I love this figure. I love Max Factory figures. I feel like they do such a good job. And I love Max Factory Mikus. So when I saw this one go up for pre-order, I knew I wanted to pre-order her. I love kneeling figures as well. She just ticked all the boxes. Like, Racing Miku, beautiful sculpt, Max Factory is making her, she's kneeling. Like, I had to have her. And knowing Max Factory, their 1/7 are definitely 1/6 scales. So I'm excited. I think she's going to be quite large, and I'm really excited to see how she turns out. So I love how they did her hair with like that pearlescent teal finish. I just think she's super gorgeous. I love the winking face. I love everything about this figure. She is just beautiful. So I'm very excited about her. She was a pretty quick pre-order for me. Maybe not instant, because she is expensive. So I had to think about it for a little bit. I had to think on it for a little bit, but in the end I did decide to pre-order her. Next up, we have September of 2023. So in September of 2023, I have the Holo Wolf and the Scent of Fruit, 1/7 scale by Good Smell Company. This one is a long way out. Like, this pre-order they put up a while ago too. Like, damn, they really put it up a long way out. But this figure is gorgeous. I love Holo, of course. And this is, I think, one of the best Holo figures I've ever seen. So I'm super, super excited to see how she turns out. Sadly, there's still another year wait for it. Oh, that's painful, but I'm very excited for that Holo. And then I also have the Aniplex 1/7 scale Kitagawa Marin figure. I absolutely love this figure. I know some people weren't sure on the face. I think the face is so perfectly Marin. I can't understand not loving this face. Like, if you don't love this face, I feel like you don't love what Marin looks like, because it looks exactly like her. I don't know. I can't fathom it. I don't get it. In my opinion, it's perfect. Like, maybe other people are seeing something I'm not seeing. It's very likely, because I'm not the best judge of faces. I like the Jabami Yumeko bunny face. We've already discussed this. I'm not the best judge of anime figure faces. But I think this Kitagawa Marin figure is so good. I think her face is perfect. I don't get it. I don't get the hate. Do you guys agree? Or do you guys also see it? Like, let me know what you think. Do you agree with me? Do you think the face is perfect? Or is she not the Marin for you? You know? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. I want to see how divided we are on this as a community. Next up, I have one figure pre-ordered right now for October of 2023, and that is the Alex Debris Vasilevia 1/6 complete figure by Astrum Design. I have loved basically all of Astrum Design's figures they've put up for pre-order, but I held off until this one. I think this figure's look is just so good. I love her, like, raincoat thing. I don't know. It's such a vibe, and, like, I love this figure so much, I actually bought the deluxe version so that I think it comes with a wall scroll of the art, so that I can get the wall scroll, because I am so obsessed with the art that this figure is based on. Like, when Astrum Design announced that they were making this figure, I fell in love instantly with the art, and then the figure turned out so gorgeous. I'm so excited. But she was really expensive. I think it was 28,000 yen for the 1/7 scale plus, like, bonus, which I think is actually pretty absurd for a figure, so damn. That one hurt to pre-order, but I am really excited about her. All right, we have two figures left. I think only two left. Let me see. Yeah, we have two figures left, one for December of 2023 and one for January of 2024. The December of 2023 figure is the Ghost Bride figure. I love this figure so much. It is definitely going to be my most expensive figure to date. But wow, this figure is absolutely breathtakingly gorgeous. I am so beyond excited for the Ghost Bride. I love Fuzutoko's art, and I think this figure is just such an art piece. Like, I can't wait to have a home one day and display it in its own, like, display in my home. I'm just so taken by the beauty of this figure. I think it is so stunning, and I cannot wait for it to be mine. And the very last figure that I have today is the Akutsu Kirara 1/7 scale, I think it's 1/7, by Native. I have been waiting for this figure. I love Raita. Again, we've established this. I love Raita. I love beautiful, tanned, beautiful, dark-skinned figures, women. They're just goddesses. I love them so much, and I want more representation in my collection. Again, I've established this many times on my channel, so I've been waiting for this figure for a very long time. I think she is absolutely breathtakingly gorgeous. I love all of the colors of this figure. I love the pose, the face, the outfit, the everything. And she finally went up for pre-order like a week ago or 2 weeks ago. Easiest pre-order of my life. I did not care what her price was. I had to have her immediately. So she comes out January of 2024, though. I can't wait. I don't want to wait, but she is absolutely gorgeous. I already waited literally like a year for her pre-order to go up. I can wait another year and a half to get her in my collection. She is just so stunning. I cannot wait to have her in my collection. I'm so glad we're finishing off on this figure because I think she is just gorgeous. I love her. I love her so much. I'm so excited. Thank you all so much for watching part two of my pre-orders video. Which pre-orders are you guys most excited to get? I'd love to hear about all of your most anticipated figures in the comments down below. So as always, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!